Now we're going to look at methods for finding the binomial probabilities for binomial probability distributions. The first method is to use the binomial probability formula. The formula is given on the screen. It's also included in your formulas and charts packet. The formula is read P of x is equal to n factorial over n minus x, that quantity factorial, and then x factorial, times p to the x times q to the n minus x, where x is a discrete random variable, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, etc. up to n. N is the number of trials. X is the number of successes among the n trials. P is the probability of a success in any one trial. And then Q is the probability of failure in any one trial. So Q is the complement of P. P and Q add up to 1. So if you have P, subtract it from 1 to find the Q. The rationale for the binomial probability formula. This first part is the number of outcomes with exactly X successes among N trials. It's also known as a combination. So it's the number of X's that can be selected from N number of items. And in your calculator, you actually have a shortcut key, that a built-in feature that will find this value for you without you having to worry about, you know, dealing with the factorial key. And that's NCR. I'll show you where it is. In other calculators, it probably is built in somewhere. You'll have to figure out where that is on your calculator, and it may very well be listed as NCX. But if you're using the TI-83, you will find NCR by pressing, well, first turn it on, and then if you press math and to the right to the PRB menu, you'll notice it's item number 3 on your calculator. We'll come back to that in a few minutes. The other part of the binomial probability formula is this product, where this is the probability of X successes among N trials for any one particular item within the trials that you're selecting from. Here's an example. Given that there is a 0.85 probability that a randomly selected adult knows what Twitter is, you are to use the binomial probability formula to find the probability that when 5 adults are randomly selected, exactly 3 of them know what Twitter is. That is, you're going to apply that binomial probability formula to find P of 3. And in the problem, you're given N is 5. Where is that? 5 adults are randomly selected. X is 3. Exactly 3 of them know what Twitter is. The probability they know what Twitter is was given in the beginning. And the probability they don't know what Twitter is, which is little q, is 1 minus p, so that gives you the 0.15. If we think again about that formula, remember it's p of x is equal to n factorial over n minus x factorial times p to the x times q to the n minus x. Plugging those values in from the previous slide, we have x is 3, n was 5, little p is 0.85, little q is 0.15. And as I mentioned, this number in the front is the number of items, the number of arrangements of taking 3 out of 5 items. You can get this number from your NCR or NCX key in your calculator without having to use that factorial key, which is the exclamation mark. In order to do that, the first thing I have to do is enter the N. In this case, it's 5. Then I go to my Math PRB menu, go down to the one I want, which is NCR. Make sure you do the one that's C in the middle. Press Enter, and then press 3 and enter, and you notice it returns that number 10. So there's 10 possible arrangements of selecting 3 out of 5 items. So if I, oh look, it's 10. Again, that's a little shortcut without having to try to deal with that factorial key. And then the other product here, or the product, the other factors, I would have 0.85 raised to the third. That's going to give me the decimal approximation listed right there. And 0.15 raised to the second is going to give me this other factor, which is the decimal approximation here. Multiplying those together, I get this decimal approximation for the probability. I'm going to round to three significant digits. And then the probability of getting exactly three adults who know Twitter among five randomly selected adults is 0.138. Now let's try a problem. Complete this example using the binomial probability formula. Too young to tat. Based on a Harris poll among adults who regret getting tattoos, 20% said they were too young when they got their tattoos. Assume that five adults who regret getting tattoos are randomly selected and find the indicated probability. This is actually a four-part problem. We'll do the first two parts in this video, and the other two parts will be done in the next video. Part A. Find the probability that none of the selected adults say that they were too young to get tattoos. Well, first, is this a binomial probability distribution? So are there two outcomes? Yes, they either say they were too young or they don't say they were too young. And is it a fixed number of trials? Yes, there are five adults. Are the trials independent? Yes, they're independent. That means that the outcome of any individual trial doesn't affect the probabilities of the other trials. And are the probabilities of success the same from trial to trial? And the answer is yes, the probabilities are the same. We have 20.20% as our probability. So this is a binomial probability distribution. I am told to use the formula, just like you will be on the test. You'll be told to use the formula. So the first thing I would recommend that you do is write the formula down. So that's P of X. It's not gonna cooperate. Okay, I got it to cooperate. P of X is equal to n factorial over n minus x factorial times P to the X times Q to the n minus X. I'm looking for none of the selected adults. So P of 0, my n is 5. That's 5 factorial. Over 5 minus 0 factorial. 0 factorial. And by the way, 0 factorial by definition is equal to 1. And then this is times our little p, which is 0.20. So that's 0.20. And remember, that's to the x, which in this case is 0, times little q, which is 0.80, because 1 minus 0.20 is 0.80, to the 5 minus 0. I can use my NCR key to find this number, so I'm going to show you how to do that. I'm going to take my calculator, I'm going to type the 5, which is my N, go to Math, go over to PRB, down to the third one, NCR, hit Enter, and then my X is 0, and that's going to return the value of 1. So while I'm here, I'm going to go ahead and type in the other numbers that I need for this. So 0.20 to the 0, do you remember what that is? Yes, any non-zero number raised to a 0 power is going to yield 1. And then 0.8 raised to the 5 minus 0 is 5. That's going to give me that probability. So my numbers are 1. Oops, get to get my pen back. So that's 1 times 1 times 0.32768. Well, 1 times 1 times 0.32768 is 0.32768. That means that my probability to three significant digits is 0.328. I'd like you to pause the video, and I'd like you to try part B. Find the probability that exactly one of the selected adults says that he or she was too young to get tattoos. When you are done, resume the video, and let's compare notes. I'm looking for the probability of exactly one. So my x is equal to 1, n is still 5, little p is equal to 0.8020, little q is equal to 0.80. I'm going to use my formula, but in this case I'm going to use a 1 for x. I've got 5 factorial still over 5 minus 1 factorial. 1 factorial, little p is 0.2 or 0.20 to the first, 0.8 to the 5 minus 1, which is 4. Remember, those numbers in the exponent have to add up to n. And then using my calculator, I'm going to type that in. So the 5 math PRB to NCR, use a 1 for x, that's going to give me a 5. 0.2 to the first should be 0.2. And then 0.8 to the fourth is going to give me 0.496. Therefore, the probability of exactly one adult saying they know, out of five, saying they know what Twitter, or that they were too young to get tattoos, is going to be NCR, which is 5 times 0.2 times 0.4096. When you multiply those together, because 0.2 times 5 is going to be 1, you're going to end up with the 0.4096, which, if you round to 3 significant digits, gives us a probability of 0.410. This problem is continued in the next videos.